The once very hot stock, Astera Labs, is crashing. Let's talk about it. Welcome back to Chipstock Investor, and welcome to our new studio. It's been a long time coming, so thanks for being patient with us. We've still got a little bit of work to do, but
we're ready. We're so ready. We hope you're ready too.
Let's talk about Astera Labs. The sponsor of today's video is Fiscal.ai. We use Fiscal for a lot of our research, and you're going to see a number of Fiscal's charts in this video.
Like this one right here, comparing the market cap of Astera Labs with its fellow upstart data center networking peer, Credo Technology. You can do a lot of financial comparisons over on Fiscal.ai's platform and then get deep insights into what you're looking at using their built-in AI chatbot.
You can get 15% off any paid plan, including their new enterprise plan with link here on the screen, fiscal.ai/CSI.
Now, Casey, in reference to that chart we just showed from fiscal.ai, you can see in the last month, stocks like Astera Labs and Credo Technology Group have pulled back quite substantially from recent all-time highs. And so we've received a lot of questions about what's happening, why did they crash? Essentially, what's the narrative? Investors want to have a reason why the stocks fell. And we've been talking a lot about this over on Semi Insider for the last week or two. And so we're just going to do a quick rundown, quick recap on this. And to start, let's maybe talk about the narrative. Let's talk about what Astera Labs, and by extension, what Credo Technology Group actually, what they actually do.
Astera primarily fits into the fabless chip designer portion of the semi industry. And typical of a fabless company, they have a little bit of IP. Astera's original product was the PCIe retimer.
And what is a retimer, I hear you asking? It is a type of analog slash digital semiconductor that receives a data signal, specifically a degraded one, that has traveled already an extensive distance across a networking cable, fully recovers the data, extracts it, retransmits a fresh copy of it, and sends it on its way through the data center. Think of this like a runner passing a baton to the next runner in the race. Now, those couple of slides we shared with you over a year ago when we did our post-IPO deep dive into Astera Labs. And since then, Astera has expanded its product portfolio beyond just the retimer.
Astera has expanded their product portfolio into fabric switches. They have memory controllers now and some Ethernet smart cable modules, as you can see from this product slide from Astera. One of the main competitors for Astera Labs would be Broadcom, the huge company that provides all of these networking supplies and so much more.
Yeah, in the past we called Marvell Technology Group baby Broadcom, and actually that was never meant to be disparaging. We understand why that might be taken that way though. There's actually a lot of baby Broadcoms though now, not just Marvell, there's also Astera Labs, Credo Technology Group, Allchip, which we did a deep dive into over on Semi Insider a month or two ago. A lot of companies trying to eat into the giant networking empire that is Broadcom hardware and also now lots of software, including VMware. Now, Casey, that is basically the narrative that has been floated out there, that companies like Astera Labs and Credo Technology have fallen in recent weeks because of new product announcements from Broadcom, new product announcements from Nvidia, by extension, also Arista Networks, which is a top purchaser of Broadcom chips and partner together in developing networking-based infrastructure for data centers. We had that video last Thursday on that. You can find the link to it in the description below or here on the screen. That's the narrative though, but there's a much more fundamental reason for why stocks like Astera Labs have fallen in recent weeks.
It's simply statistics. It's been an absolutely historic run since the tariff tantrum in April, as you can see from this chart that we showed you earlier. Credo, Astera Labs having massive gains. And I'm sure it's pretty obvious, but I think we'll say it. Stocks can do more than just go up and to the right.
They do. coins have heads and tails, one on each side.
That's right. Stocks go up, but they also go down. Volatility is a thing.
Now, the argument against this being just simply statistics is that, well, Astera and Credo and other small businesses as well have been growing like crazy this year, and especially anything related to AI and data center compute has really been going nuts. As we talked about last year, a lot of these businesses are almost acting as a sort of proxy for the rollout of NVIDIA's Blackwell systems that have been in full force now for over a year. You can see the revenue here for both Astera and Credo, incredible triple-digit year-over-year increases, especially for Credo, which gets, oddly enough, a lot less attention than Astera Labs. And in tandem with that, not to be overlooked, this is not just a revenue growth story. Both companies have actually flipped to profitability on all counts. This is a look at just Astera Labs profitability, since that's the primary company under scrutiny right now. Pretty incredible growth here, especially in free cash flow in Q2 of 2025.
Huge increase in free cash flow, coming from $6 million to $133 million in Q2 2025, with a 69% free cash flow margin. And that just can't last forever.
It can't?
Nope.
Yeah, not even Broadcom generates that kind of free cash flow margin. This is not indicative just of a company going from very small to very robust in size. This is very much a company that is participating in a booming market. So it would be safe to assume that that free cash flow margin moderates through the second half of 2025 as those reports come in. We're expecting one from Astera here in the next couple of weeks as Q3 earnings season gets started in earnest. And of course, headed into 2026, expect that growth rate and margin to moderate. In fact, the Q3 guidance for Astera actually implies just under 100% year-over-year growth compared to 150% in the last quarter. So things will moderate. And so the market has this way of being a coin flip on a daily basis. The stock could go up or the stock could go down, but over longer periods of time, especially an extended period, 6 months plus of nearly uninterrupted up into the right growth for Astera, at some point the stock just needs to moderate. The valuation still has to match the present financial reality and the near future, the near-term outlook financial reality. And it's pretty much that simple. That's all that's happened.
Here's Astera Labs and Credo on a price to sales ratio. Currently, Astera Labs is almost 60x price to sales. And even if they double their revenue over the course of the next year, that would be 30x price to sales. So pretty wild.
Yeah, that's a hefty valuation, especially for a hardware business. Yes, Astera Labs has the software that they attach to their networking chips to help their customers manage that infrastructure that they install. But ultimately, the sales are based on hardware, which is cyclical. And so for as great a story as this has been for Astera Labs, let's call it 30x forward price to sales. For a cyclical business, who knows when the cycle turns from booming growth to perhaps some sort of pause or maybe even a brief decline in data center infrastructure build-out. For Astera specifically, it's just a high valuation. Sometimes the coin lands on tails, not just heads, day in and day out. So any reason to panic? I don't know. If you zoom out, I think you have a lot of reason to be happy with your investment, even in spite of recent turbulence in the last couple of weeks.
Thanks, everybody, for tuning in to this episode of Chipstock Investor. Make sure you hit the subscribe button, like the video, share with your friends, and join us over on Semi Insider. You can get access to our Discord server. And we've got some really amazing things planned here for the fourth quarter over on our website. Check it out, chipstockinvestor.com. See y'all soon.